Hey friends, it's Jay Rye. Thanks for coming back to the channel. Today we're in Anaheim, California at the Disneyland Resort. We're checking out Winnie the Pooh. Did you know Winnie the Pooh had his own ride? Well, it hasn't been there forever. It's been there about 18 years, and they thought this ride was going to be so popular that they gave it its own area all the way back in Critter Country because they thought there were going to be monumental crowds. Didn't quite work out that way, but let's talk about all things Winnie the Pooh at Disneyland. Thanks for coming. So long before there was a Winnie the Pooh attraction at Disneyland, there were multiple other attractions that were in the area. First, in the 1970s, was Bear Country and the attraction, the Country Bear Jamboree. Really fun, used a lot of animatronics, singing bears, singing, dancing. It was a whole great show. You had the moose and the buffalo and the deer head on the wall that were talking as well. And it was a lot of fun. That attraction still exists in Walt Disney World to this day, but they decided to take this out of Disneyland because they wanted to put in Winnie the Pooh. And they didn't want to put Winnie the Pooh in Fantasyland because they felt Fantasyland was a bit too tight on space. And so they said, let's put it out in sleepy old Critter Country because all that's out there is Splash Mountain, which they added in 1989, and the Country Bear Jamboree, which wasn't that busy anymore. So they said, let's put it out there. It took some time to get the final designs down for the Winnie the Pooh attraction, but when they finally did, they completely remodeled the building that the Country Bears had been in and made a dark attraction. So again, that's a dark attraction is a slow-moving ride that is basically telling the story of your favorite characters. They have the famous ones in Fantasyland like Peter Pan, Snow White, Pinocchio, Mr. Toad, Alice, and Winnie the Pooh gets his own spot out in Critter Country. This was finally opened in 2003. Personally, I wasn't a huge fan at the opening because I had so much nostalgia for Country Bear Jamboree, which they had multiple shows. They had the Country Bear Jamboree, they had the Country Bear Vacation Hoedown, they had the Country Bear Christmas Special. So over the years, I had seen that show so many times and it was such a tradition that when they announced they were putting in Winnie the Pooh, I wasn't loving it. But I will say over time, it has definitely grown on me. And I think that they've done an excellent job in the way that they themed it. It's like you come into Critter Country, you see Splash Mountain. Of course, it's so overwhelmingly big and such a thrill attraction. And then as you round the bend, you get to Winnie the Pooh, which is by this sleepy little creek. You've got critter noises and animal noises going on in the forest beyond. So it fits in really well exactly where they put it. So I'm a little bit less of a hater these days. The theming is great, like I said, and you even get to hear your favorite characters just as you're waiting in line, as short as it may be.
Hello up there, it's me, Tigger, T-I-double-G-R, and being safe is what Tiggers like best, so please stay in your seats, with your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside, and grown-up types, please watch your little kids, T-T-F-N, ta-ta for now.
Thank you, Tigger. Now, let's take a look again at more of the ambiance here. So, a lot of this was already here when they had Country Bear Jamboree, this creek, which goes all the way from the back of what was Bear Country, now is Critter Country, goes all the way out to the rivers of America. This bridge that we're crossing just as we enter the line for Winnie the Pooh goes over that creek, right? So beautiful. And all of that's been there for many, many years. This is the train trestle that goes right through Splash Mountain and goes right over your head while you're in line for the Winnie the Pooh attraction. No train going at this moment, but it is beautiful to be under this. And as you're in line, yeah, you're directly across from Splash Mountain. So it all is themed in right together. It's gorgeous. The trees, everything looks like it was all built together at the same time, which it wasn't. All of this was done decades apart, but they made a wonderful job theming it together. And we get a sneak preview here of our little honey mobiles disappearing into this barn, if you will. What would you call those? They're sort of like beehives, I guess. But yeah, that's what we're going to be boarding momentarily. And without any further ado, here is the many adventures of Winnie the Pooh.
goodness gracious!
Take a very close look up at that wall right there. We're going to talk about that later.
What a wonderful dream.
Wake up. Ooh. Wake up. Wake up.
All right, so there it is, The Many Adventures of Winnie the Pooh. Now, if you see here, this is exactly what I was talking about earlier, how the stream goes all the way from the back of Critter Country all the way to the rivers of America. So this is where the stream starts. It comes out of the hill, and yeah, it goes all the way to the rivers of America, and that has been there for, gosh, almost 50 years now. Bear Country would have been 50 years old in 2022, which is coming up shortly. If you're a big Winnie the Pooh fan, you'll notice that they kind of mixed multiple Winnie the Pooh stories together to make this attraction. You've got parts of The Blustery Day in there, and some people have criticized it because it's a bit of a mishmash, you know, it doesn't really follow a cohesive story. But you know what, I say if you like Winnie the Pooh, just, you know, enjoy the characters, and you will like the ride just for that fact. Now, I did say to pay very close attention to the upper part of the wall that I was focusing on. The reason I said that is because they put a great Easter egg into this attraction. Up on that wall are the three heads that were still in the Country Bear Jamboree. Max, Buff, and Melvin, who were the talking, game heads that were in the Country Bear Jamboree making wisecracks, are still in Winnie the Pooh. Now you have to crane your neck, look backwards, and they're not lit. They're in the dark. So they are very difficult to see. But I love when Disney does this. You know, they put an extra little thought. They put these extra little Easter eggs, which are fun things for the people like me that are nostalgic about what the ride used to be. And, you know, you go on Winnie the Pooh, you turn your head, you still get to see a piece of Country Bear Jamboree. And if there's other people sitting with you, they're like, what the heck are those people doing? But hey, we know the secrets. So here's another really cool thing about Critter Country. When you get off of the Winnie the Pooh ride, not only is there a store with full of candy, but you can meet the characters, all right? You get off of the Many Adventures of Winnie the Pooh, and you get right into line. You can take your kids to get pictures, or maybe it's not even for your kids. Maybe it's for you. They've got all of the classic Pooh characters there, and it's like you wait in line, and you go like around the bend, and you get to see like all the characters at their different spots. So these pictures here, or this video, I should say, is empty, right? So it's during pandemic. So I got to actually get really great shots of all the photo locations without the characters and without all the gazillion people, because the characters have to be put, you know, somewhere else during this time. So really cool set pieces here on how they make it happen. This is the entrance where you get in line and then meet all of those characters. They really did some great theming in the area, and it didn't take much, you know, because it really felt like the Hundred Acre Woods was a part of Critter Country. And if you look carefully there in the back, Teddy Bear Swingin' Arcade, that is named after Teddy Bear, who was in the Country Bear Jamboree. So there's another little Easter egg for you. And Pooh Corner took over for what was Crocodile Mercantile, and before that was, oh darn it, I can't remember at the top of my head, but that store has changed names multiple times from back in the day, but they still are the original buildings from when it was Bear Country, all the way back almost 50 years ago. So there's one more look back at the Pooh meet and greets while they are empty. Get a good look at that, because once the pandemic is over, you will see lines all over again. Well, Pooh Bear, I gotta say, you got the best neighbors from your attraction as well, because you're right next to Splash Mountain, of course, home of Brer Bear, Brer Rabbit, Brer Fox, for a limited time, because apparently they are going to be getting rid of all of those characters from Splash Mountain, which is such a bummer. Pooh Bear and Splash Mountain have gone hand in hand as critters of Critter Country, so it's going to be a little weird for Princess Tiana to move in next door, but I don't know. They'll figure it out somehow, I guess. But yeah, this has been a great, great placement for Winnie the Pooh. I like it better than Disney World's, because Disney World, it's just a regular building, you know, where they stuck Winnie the Pooh. This place is much cooler. And look at all the theming, you know? Oh, look at these trees. Look at the train trestle, all of that wood. You've got the stream. You've got the empty line. It's beautiful, though, you know? It really does feel like the Hundred Acre Woods. This is the best theming of any of the Pooh attractions I've seen at any of the parks. So, excellent job there for sure. Disney, you did it. You did a fantastic job. All right. This is The Many Adventures of Winnie the Pooh. It's Disneyland's attraction. It's their version of the Winnie the Pooh ride. Thank you so much for watching. It's J-Rai World right here on YouTube and on Instagram. Thank you so much for watching. Hit the subscribe button. Hit that like button. Leave me a comment. What do you think of Winnie the Pooh? Should they have taken out Country Bear Jamboree? Is this a good attraction for the kids? Leave a comment. We'll talk about it. See you next time. Bye.